Good day, everyone. Garage King here, and we are going to find out when you're installing a catch can or buying a kit or maybe just doing mods on your vehicle if the Elite Engineering high flow valves are worth it. These are for 3/8 inside diameter pipe. Most catch can kits just come with these regular sort of universal type valves. This is what they all come with, just a one-way valve. And here's another one I found online, this one here. It's labeled as a high flow valve, so I want to check it. So how are we going to check it? We're going to set up some instruments and I'm going to show you. Now, the one thing I found is if you shake these valves, nothing happens. And if you shake this one, you can hear it. So there's a type of check ball inside of this valve, where these ones probably just have rubber flapper valves. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to apply flow similar to that which we would probably see in a vehicle. And then we're going to measure the pressure drop across each valve. Okay, so if we look at what we're doing here with the air pressure, this obviously isn't going to work because if you can see, the two gauges are not reading the same. So we can't do a pressure drop. This would have been the optimum test, but I have another plan just to use one gauge. This really sucks. I really wanted to use two and measure the pressure drop, but I can't do it. But what we can do is we can measure the back pressure with one gauge. All right, so we have our air source there and you can see we're just over 10 pounds, which is fine. And the compressor is plenty big, so it's not gonna cut on. And what'll happen is it'll just provide a constant airflow through the regulator at just over 10 pounds. And then what I'll do is I'm not even gonna touch the compressor. I'm just gonna interchange the valves and then we can just see how much a restriction the valves cause. So let's do it. All right, so I may have to do a voice overlay. We'll see how it all works out. Depending on how noisy this is, I don't know if you're gonna be able to hear me or not, so we'll see if I do a voice overlay. So we'll start with this valve first. We have it in backwards so we can tell the one way works perfectly because there's 10 pounds pressure, or just slightly over 10 pounds pressure, and nothing is coming out. So we know this valve works, so let's take it out, spin it around, and see how much back pressure we have. And there you can see we're at 2 psi, so it's providing a little bit of back pressure. Not a lot, but it is providing back pressure. So we got 2 PSI. So let's try the next one, see what happens. Now first I put it in backwards just to see how well it'll work. And if you can hear, the one-way valve isn't even working properly on it because air is still getting through. So now let's see how much restriction this valve causes. And we can see this valve is actually quite restrictive. We're at 4 pounds. So this one is restricting a lot of the airflow that is coming through. So very restrictive valve. Actually, I wouldn't even want this one on my car. So let's go to the Elite. All right, and we're back up to 10 or just over 10. And there is no airflow. So we can tell the one-way portion works fine. So let's flip it around and see what happens for airflow. And now it's flipped around from airflow, and you can see we're at 1 pound. So with 1 pound, that's a little bit of a restriction, but really not a lot. So it's twice as efficient as this one. Because if you remember this one, which comes with most of the kits, is 2 pounds. So now with 2 pounds, so this one is twice as restrictive as the Elite one. So the Elite one's actually really, really good. And then if we move back to this one's kind of just an embarrassment. That's way too restrictive. Basically, we had 10 pounds. We're back to around 4.5 to 5. So this is restricting half of our airflow. So that's really unacceptable to restrict half of your airflow. That's just nuts. So, and this one was even labeled as a high flow valve when I found it. So just a terrible valve. So let's go back again. You can see, there you go. We're still at 2 pounds, and we'll go to the Elite.
And there you go, we're at 1 pound. So you can see the difference between the valves. 1 pound. 2 pounds. 4.5 pounds. So quite a difference between these two valves. And this one, I'm actually ashamed of it because the one-way valve portion didn't even work properly. These ones, the one-way valve did work properly, but the Elite definitely had a really good airflow.
So that was a really cool test. It was valid. It showed just how much the Elite flowed compared to your second best, or I guess your average one-way check valves. These are the ones that are really, really popular. And then this one was just an embarrassment. So the test was good. I'm going to throw up a chart here because I just want to mention something. Someone may say, oh, but our cars don't see 10 pounds pressure, so your test wasn't valid. We got to get that 10 pounds out of our head because it's not about pressure. It's about airflow and restriction. That's what it's about. I could have just had easily, if I would have had a vacuum source, but I don't, I could have hooked a vacuum source up here and just had it suck this way, and it would have went this way instead of pressure going this way. And the only difference would have been, instead of the needle being on this side, the needle would have been on this side. That would have been the only difference, but the valves would have still performed just the same. So it wouldn't have made a difference. The test is valid. So anyway, another thought that came to my mind is maybe that's why they want to avoid warranty sometime. I don't know. If you get a really bad valve, I mean, it could screw up your system, I guess, your airflow, because you want to have as least restriction as possible. So for me, I don't mind spending the extra money as long as I get something for it. And with the Elite, you do. You get something for it, so I don't mind spending the money. So that's it for my video this week. Hopefully you guys enjoy. Any questions, comments, concerns, leave them below. GarageKing over and out, and I will see you on the next one. Thanks, everyone.